Hi guys, today we will be dealing about SRCC, that is Sri Ram College of Commerce. It is one of the best colleges known for commerce stream all over India. So if you are wishing to get into the one of the leading institute for commerce in India, then it is Sri Ram College of Commerce. So in today video, we will be having a video session with the SRCC student, namely Garima Sopti. So let's move on to the screen.
Hi. Today we have a new guest from SRCC, Garima Sopti. So Garima, over to you. Give some introduction.
Yeah, so hello guys. I'm Garima Sopti. I am currently pursuing BCom honors from Sri Ram College of Commerce, SRCC. So I am in my third year currently. So I have mostly experienced everything in the college and I'm here to sum it up.
Good to know that. So Garima, we will be asking, since most of the 12th students have the question about the board preparation, so it will be a good if you give some of the tips to the 12th standard guys.
So for all those who are currently in their 12th class or in their 11th class, and they want to get into Delhi University or Sri Ram College of Commerce specifically, so I want to suggest them two principles that they should follow in their life. First is consistency and second is discipline.
Okay.
I feel that if you follow both these principles, then you will be able to achieve it. So there are some pointers that I would like to mention here. So start your preparation from the first day itself, from day one, and don't lag it till the end, because what I used to do is I used to study it in the school, then I used to go home and study it for the tuition classes and then do my homework. So for that I was able to revise it 3 to 4 times even before my examination begin. So you can adopt this strategy. Secondly, take your weekly test as well as your CPTs very seriously. So if you are given 2 chapters to prepare for the weekly test, give your 100% at that time so that it would be easier for you to prepare at the end during the final examinations.
Okay.
Apart from this, it is very important for you to revise and practice again and again. It's the strategy. If you just do it once, you can't get it there.
Okay,
and
continue.
Just one thing more is, even if you don't get there, just don't get stay confident on yourself. Even if you are in any other college apart from SRCC, try to explore your opportunities in that college itself, like through LinkedIn.
So you mentioned all the LinkedIn. Then Garima, we would be asking some of the study schedule or tips. If you may give related to the commerce section, it would be better for the students of 12th standard. So if you could mention it.
As I mentioned, practice is very important. So if you are taking up a practical subject, then try to solve the questions regularly, and you should be updated with all the chapters that have been done in the school. And for the theoretical subjects, I want to mention that you should learn it by writing. In subjects like business studies, you can write the headings for all the questions, so that that will help you to retain the same for a longer period of time. And if you make some schedules, then follow it consistently and with discipline. So that's the key that you can reach such a good college and score a good percentage.
Okay. That's the strategy behind it.
Yeah.
Can you please brief the sum of cutoff and eligibility criteria of the SRCC?
So this time, if I say it's 99.5% for Eco, and 99% for BCom honors. So usually in SRCC, the BCom cutoffs are less than the ECO cutoffs, but this time the tables have turned. So at my time when I was there to take admission in SRCC, my cutoff for BCom honors was around 98 or 98.25%, whereas for ECO honors is for 98.75%.
Okay.
And if you talk about other reserved categories, SC, STs, OBCs, and PWD, their percentage varies from 85 to 94%.
Okay.
And even science students can take admissions in SRCC. Till last year, we had a 5% deduction criteria for the science students. This time, I don't know. I feel that they don't have this cutoff this time.
Okay. Good to know that science students could also pursue that.
Yeah.
And what about the admission procedure of SRCC?
Talking about the admission procedure, in my case, it was completely offline. After the cutoffs are declared, you have to fill a form on the Delhi University portal, and then you have to go to the college, and then you have to fill forms and submit most essential documents like CBSE certificates and your 12th class mark sheet, your 10th class mark sheets. But now it is completely online. So the faculty and the staff, the students in SRCC are very cooperative to say, and they helped me a lot during the entire admission process. Even when we were in our second year, we were also approached to come and help first year students to get settled down. So that's a very great thing in SRCC.
Okay, good. Then what are the courses offered in SRC? Could you brief some of the listed courses?
So, most importantly, summing it up, there are two courses offered mainly, which are BCom honors and ECO honors.
Okay.
That BA Economics, while in the rest of the Delhi University colleges, there are extra courses offered too. But even we receive mails regarding French courses or German courses, which we could take up, but we have to make extra payment for it.
Okay.
And we also have a global business operations, which is a kind of a master's degree in business.
Means huge number of opportunities are there if you reach there. Okay.
Yeah, absolutely.
Then what are the tips for the freshers that have taken admission in the SRCC? How would you guide them?
So first of all, if you have made it to SRCC, be proud on yourself, be confident, because that's a great thing to do. And when you come to college, the competition doesn't end there. The competition will begin. And when we were in school, we feel that, okay, we were the best in our school or in our district. But when you went to college, there are alike people or better people, and you have to accept that fact.
Yes.
And that's a very good thing that SRCC teaches you. You learn to face rejections. I just want to say that if you enter SRCC and if you feel that there's a lot of competition and you can't survive it, just stay confident on yourself, and you can easily manage the pressure. You will learn it in SRCC.
Okay. Thanks for the tips for the freshers. Then what are the growth opportunities that you may discuss for the students that are pursuing the SRCC graduation?
So there are immense amount of opportunities. You get exposure to societies. There are a lot of societies in SRCC for each and everything. Like we have computer society, we have maths, we have commerce society, economics society. Then a sports society, dramatic society, music society, dance society. So if you you have a passion for anything, there is a society in SRCC for it.
Okay.
And apart from this, it also offers you international exposure. Even I have taken part in international programs where you meet international students and you interact and spend some time with them. So that's a great thing. And apart from this, the placements, we all know that how SRCC placements are so high, and there are so many companies that come, and you get a lot of exposure there too.
Could you list some of the company that comes to SRCC?
McKinsey comes. Then there is FTI Consulting, Dahlberg, Bain, and then EY, and the Big Fours that we all know. And like there is each and every company from small to the large one. Okay. All of them come to SRCC, and there are immense opportunities for everyone there out.
Okay, thanks for it. Then one more question, that is, what's the CTC for it? That is the cost to company that a student gets the whole year package.
So on average, average package in SRCC is around 8 to 9 lakhs.
Okay.
And for the highest package, it is 31 lakhs.
Good to know.
31 lakhs for the last year.
Yeah. And what are the some of the fests that are organized in SRCC?
So first of all, we have the biggest fest of Delhi University, which is Crossroads. So the biggest speakers and biggest actors, singers, dancers come to our college, and there is a lot of crowd those days. And then we have Business Conclave, which is also an flagship event of SRCC, where there are a lot of events organized, a lot of speakers from economic background, from commerce background coming in. Coming and telling about themselves, and how even Sundar Pichai came, Narendra Modi came.
Good to know.
So all these big big personalities also come and share with us. And then we have society fest also, like each and every society organize their own fest. So if you are a part of the society, you learn research skills, organizing skills, then you raise money from the companies. So there are a lot of opportunities if you become part of societies.
Okay. Then what are the higher studies guidelines that you may provide for the juniors, your juniors?
So, first of all, it's very difficult at this stage to foresee what you want to pursue. Yeah. Many might be able to see that, okay, I want to get into finance or I want to get into sales, but many people might not be able to judge. So I just want to tell them that you need to explore. And secondly, since there are a lot of placement opportunities, apart from that, you can pursue MBA, you can pursue CA, CS, CMA, and FRM. So there are a lot of courses that you can pursue with your BCom honors degree or Eco honors. So that's totally depends upon what you want to pursue ahead. Like I am very, I'm a finance enthusiast, so I wanted to pursue CA or CFA. So I can do that with a BCom honors. And if you don't, if you're not willing to do MBA directly after your college and you want to gain some job experience, then there are immense placement opportunities and internship opportunities for you as well.
Okay. So that was all about SRCC. Summing up that, we came to know that Garima also has started a startup. So Garima, could you explain some of the points of it?
Yeah, so I'm the co-founder of Chop Chop Finance. Since I told I love finance.
Yeah.
So it's about two people. So first of all, one of the category is those who love finance and want to make a career in it, like the investment banking or private equity. So we provide some financial models to them or some ebooks. Then we have our daily articles on the life of an investment banker or the skills required for them. And on the other hand, there are second category of people who will or who are earning money. Because earning money is good, but managing is something that is required today.
Yes, yes, yes.
So we raise awareness about personal finance, insurance, and saving money, investing it. So that's about it. So you can follow it on LinkedIn, and you can even message me or follow my account.
I will provide all the details, all your links in the description of the video. Okay. So guys, do follow her and do subscribe to her channel.
Yeah. Even I saw his channel, and there is a lot of stuff and learning about various courses. And I feel that many videos will also be coming ahead for all the guidance. So that's a great job you are doing. And it was a pleasure to interact with you.
Good to hear that. Thank you very much. That's all about it.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Hope this video session has helped you a lot and will help to the student who are thinking of taking an admission in Sri Ram College of Commerce. So these all are the highlights of it. So if you want to take, then go for it. Since it is not only video for the Delhi University, we will be uploading video sessions with each and every college student. That is from today, it is SRCC, then it will be continuing with other colleges of Delhi University too. So subscribe to the channel so that you may not miss any of the college. So if this video have helped you, then do like it, share with your friends and ask them to subscribe it too. That's all for today's video. Until then, bye bye.